Graham Pictures presents The Winning Mix for 86. In February, Hannah and her sisters.
There's something very lovely and real about Hannah. She gives me a very deep feeling of being part of something.
Did you ever read this one? Elliot, don't!
Lee, I'm in love with you.
You mentioned to me yourself that you and Elliot were having some problems.
You were having problems, and problems that are my business, which I don't see how you could know about in such detail.
It's a good thing we had a talented daughter.
I can only hope that she was mine. With you as her mother, her father could be anybody in Actors Equity.
2 months ago, you thought you had a malignant melanoma.
Naturally, I had the sudden appearance of a black spot on my back.
It was on your shirt.
I'm gonna cry. You want my husband to have a child with you?
Yeah, don't answer now. Just, you know, take it home and think about it for a while.
God, I should have married you years ago when you wanted to. I should have agreed.
Oh, God, don't you know it never would have worked?
It's an epiphany of the soul, if you know what I mean.
No, I know exactly what you mean, darling.
I don't know if you remember me, but we had the worst night of my life together.
Also in February, FX.
Raleigh Tyler is an FX man, the movie's master of make-believe. He can show you 1,000 ways to die.
Wake up! Cut! Great special effects.
But now somebody wants Raleigh Tyler to do it for real.
We want to stage a fake assassination, Raleigh, and we want you to supervise it.
Who's the we?
Justice Department.
I'm a special effects man. I deal in make-believe. I'd like to keep it like that.
We just thought that we might be able to utilize your particular genius to help us out.
And what if someone takes a shot at me?
You are 100% protected. I give you my word.
That job that guy wanted me to do? I think I'll do it.
But someone else is writing the script and casting him as the killer.
I haven't done anything.
What if we put in real bullets?
If one person suspects.
I'm sorry, Raleigh. No loose ends.
Listen up to something. He tried to kill me.
You go directly to the newspapers.
What makes you think they believe me?
I believe you.
My name is Leo. We need to talk.
Where the hell are you, Tyler?
He's going to need every trick from every movie he's ever made.
Remember my particular genius.
Just to get even. And get out alive.
I'm in pursuit of a blue step van. Letters on the side. X as in Frank, X as in X-ray.
Remember Skidball Express?
I sure do!
Leo!
Son of a gun, you faked us out.
But Raleigh Tyler's most special effects are yet to come.
Forget why you hired me.
What
next? At the next corner, send Nelly in!
Oh my God, what?
Is he the weapon? Or the victim? Is it murder? Or is it FX?
In March, just between friends.
3, 2, 1.
Rolling.
This is Stanley.
Relax.
What's her name? She looks very familiar.
Sandy Dunlap. She's on the news.
A celebrity.
Two women drawn together as friends.
Bye. Other side.
A family woman considering a career.
She is terrific. I hope you're paying her what she's worth.
$20 a lesson?
That's not enough. Hold out for more.
How'd you get into it? News, I mean.
Well, I started out as a weather girl in Indianapolis. You know, your basic 22-year-old airhead. My producer knew it, right? So he told me that he would renew my option if I would just do him this small horizontal favor every now and then.
A career woman thinking about a family.
I've always said that if the right guy comes along, I'd just do it. Well, I've met him.
What about Saturday? You could come for dinner.
What time would you like me?
Aren't you the one who interviewed my dad?
Your dad?
At the Seismology Center?
Mimology? I didn't know that.
Yet they share something in common.
Hi.
It's Sandy Dunlap.
Somehow Holly just met Sandy. She's in the kitchen right now. Here. Mm-hmm.
Sandy? Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. Listen, just let me handle this, will you? Don't do anything to give it away.
Sure.
I know how you are about meeting people, so this is going to make everything so much more comfortable for you.
Why didn't you tell me you were happily married?
Hey, I never said I was unhappily married.
I love her.
I love you.
I love you, too.
I mean, you're not the kind of guy that does this kind of thing.
Mary Tyler Moore.
I didn't know you when I met him. You gotta believe me.
It's all right. As long as you don't know the wife. Is that what you're saying?
Christine Lottie.
You're not my friend! But I need one, Holly. I'm pregnant.
Ted Danson.
I just don't want to think that I'll never see you again.
Sam Waterston.
What's bothering me is seeing you risk losing Holly. She's the best woman I know.
What the hell am I going to do?
Just Between Friends. Also in March, Hell Camp.
This is the toughest escape and evasion course in the military. Most do not get through it. The course has not been altered to accommodate you.
Close off now! Oh, what's the matter, Missy? You need some help, huh?
Yesterday, they were the elite of America's fighting forces.
My job is to cull you out and step on you.
Now, they are animals. To be lied to and humiliated.
I am the one and only. I am the Almighty. I am the God here, and I am a vengeful God.
Imagine a nightmare from which there is no waking, where your greatest fears and deepest secrets are exposed.
Logic will not serve you. This is what it's really about.
Imagine you have been abandoned to Hell Camp.
Victor's out of control!
Listen, Logan, I can't lay down and die. I won't!
But there's something very wrong here.
Hell Camp. Where civilization ends and survival begins. In April, at close range.
Yesterday, he was a nobody. Today, he is front page news.
Your name? Brad, little Brad, Brad Jinger.
And is there a Big Brad? Who is he?
He's my father.
A man too dangerous to get close to. A boy too dazzled to break away. Sean Penn is Brad Whitewood Jr. A live wire kid in a dead end town. Yearning for a family he's never known.
Hi.
Oh, I'm Terry.
You have a really nice smile.
Thanks.
Guess you must have heard about me. I heard you was a thief.
Well, some folks sound just the devil in blue suede shoes. 100? 20.
When I married him, he had the biggest eyes you ever saw.
What do you think?
Beautiful.
And he courted me like a regular gentleman.
Don't never say I've done nothing for you.
He found the father to idolize, the girl to love. Now he has to find himself.
I see something in you.
The caretaker's light just went on.
I see you got something.
Oh, Brad.
Don't move at all.
Don't even think about it.
Tell me about your uncle. Will he really take us?
Yeah! His land goes on forever. And they got jobs there, too.
Yeah!
I love you, huh?
What's my son saying?
Terry and I are leaving. We're getting out of here.
They haven't really started on it yet.
Somebody got killed. You know too much, you think too much, you talk too much. That's it.
I don't want no part of this.
Liar!
Dad,
is this the gun you used? I gave you money, I gave you a car, I took you in. But don't that mean something?
Family gun, Dad.
I love you. Is that what you want to hear?
I love you too, Dad.
Sean Penn, Christopher Walken. Like father, like son, like hell. At close range.
In May, miracles.
I told you one stick was enough.
Roger and Jean have a problem. After only 12 hours of blissful divorce,
oh my God,
they can't stop running into each other.
Are you all right? Jean.
Roger.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
In the next 2 days, they'll have an adventure of a lifetime.
Where the hell would you be if you didn't have that gun? Answer me that, huh?
With this.
But they may or may not survive. They're going to be kidnapped.
Tied up.
Ow!
Shot at. Hijacked. Left for dead.
Roger, look.
They're vultures. They won't eat you out of professional courtesy.
Banged up. Swept away.
This is the last damn straw.
Marooned. Lost in the jungle. Busted out of jail.
Doc!
Doc?
Stoned. Roger and Jean, their marriage never had a prayer. And it's going to take a miracle to save their divorce.
I think I have the hang of it now.
Tom Conti.
Son of a bitch.
Terry Garr.
Son of a bitch.
Paul Rodriguez.
Son of a bitch.
And Christopher Lloyd.
Son of a bitch.
Miracles. In June, back to school.
Pocahontas, how are you, huh? Ophelia, hold some of my calls.
Thornton Mellon should be a happy man.
Oh, take it easy, will you? Take it easy. And don't get any on the walls.
He's got a booming business.
The Melon Patch Kids are not orphans. They're abandoned.
And a devoted wife.
Are you saying I spent too much money?
A lot of people go to Switzerland to get their watch fixed. I'm an earth sign, she's a water sign. Together we made mud.
Only one thing was missing.
I'm going to college.
A college education.
Look what they teach you here. Here's a book on sex education.
Let me see that.
The world's oldest living freshman.
Well, he left out the most important thing. Where to get it?
What a woman.
She is the teacher.
You know, I like teachers. Why don't you call me sometime when you have no class?
He's not just the big man on campus.
Hey, folks, it's on me. Shakespeare for everyone, okay? Yeah! You too, honey. Ooh, I like to tame your shrew.
He's the wildest man on campus.
The football team at my high school, they were tough. After they sacked the quarterback, they went after his family.
Rodney Dangerfield, back to school. Come on, I'll work it all out.
In July, Haunted Honeymoon.
We have him in an ideal situation. A lonely estate, miles from anywhere.
I can be feeling swell, right on top of the world, and all of a sudden something sets it off, and then I'm just scared to death.
What? I know that one of you is a werewolf.
Ah! Holy baloney, here we go again.
Something terrible's happened. I just found Cousin Francis in my bed, dead.
Was he wearing a dress?
Yes, he was.
Just ask him to leave, sir. Tell him you have a headache.
Larry, I don't think...
Don't argue with me, honey.
Hey, you're steady.
You do the eagle rock with style and grace.
Dom DeLuise, Gilda Radner, and Gene Wilder in Haunted Honeymoon.
Also in July, Cherry 2000.
In the future, the world has survived. Romance has not.
Right, so we'll say a dinner, complete sexual encounter, optional episode in the morning, right?
I gotta run this past my own lawyer.
Pleasure is strictly business. But it will be possible to have the perfect mate. A Cherry 2000.
Looks great.
Thanks.
Thoughtful. Desirable. She'll never run out on him. Just short out.
I'm sorry, kid. Total internal meltdown. Now, you got her basic memory right here. Vocal patterns, verbal, whatever, basic voice. Don't look so glum. Your chassis's out for the count, all right? You got the chip. You go in, you pick yourself out a new model. You slide it in the slot. You got yourself your girl back in a brand new frame.
Give me a call if you find a Cherry. Cherry 2000.
Look, my friend, you're going to be a very old man, round in the middle and bone dry before you find one of those in these parts.
That's a chance I'll just have to take.
Then, the adventure begins.
Why don't you hire a tracker to go into Zone 7?
We got a policy against trackers in these parts.
Nobody goes into Zone 7.
You know, they got one of the original warehouses down there. Girls stacked on the shelves like pies.
I'm looking for someone to go into Zone 7.
I'm E. Johnson. You're not going to find anybody better than me, mister. I'm not a machine. Do you know where they keep these babies? We call it the graveyard. It is the worst place in the zone. Well, maybe I can get in there and find this thing, but I need somebody riding shotgun in order to make it out in one piece.
I want you to chase those birds till they drop.
If you think it's tough to meet the right people now, wait till you go looking for a Cherry 2000.
And in the fall, Hoosiers.
To the little town of Hickory, Indiana, basketball is king.
You're not the new coach.
And Norman Dale.
Oh, are you expecting somebody else?
Yeah, an experience teaching?
An intruder.
Tell me something, am I being interviewed here?
He won't play politics.
Well, first of all, let's be real friendly here, okay? My name is Norm. Secondly, your coaching days are over.
Just ball.
Five players on the floor function as one single unit. Team, 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 right? Oh, come on!
I think it's gonna work out.
It's gotta work out this time, or that's it for good.
He's making enemies faster than points.
What kind of point nut stunt you trying to pull out there?
You start screwing up this team,
I'll personally hide strap your ass to a pine rail and send you up the Monon line.
Welcome to Indiana basketball.
I hate to tell you this, Mr. Dale, but it's only a game. It's a nice game. It's only...
Why so unfriendly, Miss Fleener?
And his own past might catch up with him.
Norman Dale, coach of the national champions Ithaca Warriors, was given a lifetime suspension to be honored by all NCAA signatories for physically assaulting his own player in Ithaca's last season's game.
I feel like I'm in the Army.
You are in the Army. You're my Army.
A petition's been issued requesting a referendum on your removal as basketball coach.
But if he can drill his method in...
Hold it!
It's time for a vote. Majority rules.
Yeah. Before they vote him out.
Remember what we worked on in practice, all right? I want to see it on the court!
He just might turn five boys into a team.
Team!
The likes of which this school, this town, and this state have never seen before. Gene Hackman, Barbara Hershey, Hoosiers. Also for the fall, Foreign Body, a sophisticated comedy of medicine and manners starring Victor Banerjee. Lionheart, the dramatic adventure of a teenage knight who crusades to save an army of orphans from enslavement and death. RoboCop, mechanical body, human memory, the ultimate law enforcement operative of the future. Something Wild, a modern American romantic thriller starring Melanie Griffiths and Jeff Daniels, directed by Jonathan Demme. Making Mr. Right, a new comedy from Susan Seidelman, director of Desperately Seeking Susan. And for Christmas, The Three Amigos, starring Steve Martin, Chevy Chase, and Saturday Night Live star Martin Short, directed by John Landis. The Winning Mix for '86 from Orion.